The world has a ton of data, and we're creating more every day. And moving all that data around can be a challenge. Azure Data Boxes help you transfer terabytes and even petabytes of data to Azure. Mathew Dickson is here to show us how it all works today on Azure Friday. Hey everyone, Donovan Brown here with another episode of Azure Friday. So tell me about these data boxes.
Data boxes are a new family of devices that we have. They're there to help you move data into Azure.
Okay, so I see there's one on the desk here. I connect it to my network? Do I ship it somewhere? Like, tell me the rhyme and reason and how I actually use it.
That's the right question. We have two different paths that we can help you get data into the environment. So we've got devices that can help you use your network.
Okay.
And for that, we've got a data box gateway.
Okay.
We're announcing a data box gateway. And we're also announcing a data box edge, which also allows you to pre-process that data before you send it into Azure.
Gotcha.
So we have a path that uses the network. And we also have a path when your network isn't enough. So you've got a lot more data than you've got network. And for that, we're announcing we have three separate devices that you can use based on the amount of data that you have that needs to move to Azure. We have Data Box, which we had announced last year, which is going GA at Ignite. We have disks, which we've also been previewing as well. So if you've got a smaller amount of data and you want to move that to Azure, we can send you disks. You can fill them up on site and send them back to Azure and we'll upload it. And we're also announcing a Data Box Heavy, which is for heavy lifting of data, large amounts of data that you want to uplift and get into Azure. And it's about a petabyte of data that it's capable of filling up and sending into Azure.
Gotcha. So if I simply don't have the bandwidth or the amount of time it would take on my pipe to get that bandwidth up there, I order one of these boxes, I shove all the data onto that particular box, I ship this back to you, and then you'll take care of making sure it gets into Azure for me.
Exactly.
All right, and then I have access to that data via Azure through any mechanisms that I want. So this is like blob storage, file storage, like what kind of, or all of that storage?
Yep, we support Azure Blob Storage, both block and page blobs, and we also support Azure Files.
Oh, awesome.
And once it's in Azure as well, you're free to transfer it around wherever you need it as well.
Gotcha, so this is just a diagram of some of the family of the different types of boxes, I'm assuming.
Yeah, family of the devices, the two different paths that you've got, the network path, where you have the Data Box gateway or the edge sitting there with one, where the data is going directly through the virtual machine that the gateway is, directly onto Azure, so you can put that on Hyper-V, VMware, wherever you may want it.
Okay.
Anything that you put on that gateway will be moved into Azure. And then the other path, the edge path, it's a physical appliance that's delivered to you from Microsoft that has not only the gateway functionality, but also the local compute capabilities so that you can analyze the data as it comes in. You can potentially reduce, you can potentially alert, you can do things with that information as it comes in prior to getting it into Azure.
Okay, perfect. So can you show me a demo of how I would connect to this or how that experience would look like if I were using it?
Sure. And so for the Data Box Gateway and Edge functionality, Andrew is just about to do, Andrew has a demo which is going to go through that whole functionality.
Awesome.
What I'm going to demo today is the offline data transfer path that we have with the data boxes itself.
Love to see it.
So great, I'll flip over here. So we actually have a data box here. This is what you would order. This is what would ship to Azure. What would ship from Azure to you.
Okay.
And I'll go through the ordering process and give you sort of details as to how this works.
Okay.
So, the simple path here, you come to your Azure portal.
Okay.
And very simply, you select the subscription where you want the data to come into, the import type, which is import into Azure, the source country, which in this case, we're supporting the United States and the EU for at the moment, and the destination region, where do I want this to end up?
So okay.
So in this case here, it's going to end up in US West, and I apply. Once I do this, what the Azure portal does is actually goes and finds me what are my various options that I have available to me. So based on the region and based on the capabilities that we have in that region, we'll show you the different devices that are capable. So in this case here, we're in the US, and you can see we've got the data box itself, which is this device here, which is the 100 terabytes of raw, 80 terabytes of usable capacity that we'll prepare and ship to you. We also have the data box disks, which is up to five USB or SATA connected disks that we will send to you. Approximately 35 terabytes of usable capacity that you might want to move up. and our Data Box Heavy, which, you know, I couldn't fit in studio here today. but that's the one where, you know, if you've got petabytes of data, this is the petabyte scale device that that we can ship out to you. But the process is very similar to them all. And so I come down, and in this case here, I want the Data Box, this guy here. I select that, and then I put in the order details, just like getting anything else shipped to me from a location.
Okay.
It's going to need my name, address.
And this order name here, this order name is just so that I have it for my own records and I can do some traceability on the order, right?
That's exactly it. This is what will show up. And so in this case, I'm going to create a new resource group for the job.
Okay. And you say a job. What is actually a job versus where my data lives?
So the job is what defines your import. It defines the storage device. It provides the encryption keys. It provides the storage accounts that it's going to come into. It's where all the tracking comes back into.
Gotcha.
So it's your way of tracking where the data box is and how it's moving through the system.
So all the data that relates to my data box will be stored inside that particular resource group.
Yes, all that relates to that job, yes.
Gotcha. And then the storage account there is where the actual data will end up.
That's correct.
Got it. Okay.
And I can select up to 10 storage accounts. So I can have up to 10 different storage accounts where that data is coming into.
Okay.
So I put in my contact details, company name, Microsoft, street address, 1020.
So you're sending this to your house? You got a lot of data at home.
This is the office. We're based in Sunnyvale.
A lot of pictures? Oh, my dog, yeah. I take a lot of pictures of my dog hybrid. I need to make sure they're safely stored.
Exactly.
Gotcha.
And I'll give out the standard movie theater.
Yes. Phone number.
And then it's going to go validate, make sure that this is a valid address. It fixed up the typos that I had in there for my zip code. Validate again.
And now we're ready to ship it.
Now it's ready.
Gotcha.
I've got all the details in there. Who's it going to notify? I get the job details. I can see job name, the storage, the subscription that it's going to come into, storage account that it's going to come into, and address where it's going to be shipped to.
Perfect.
And so from here, it's going to go through and do that order.
Okay.
And what will happen is we'll prepare this device in our data center for you. So in that case there, it gets prepared with the right levels of encryption. So it's a secure device when it's shipping. So we put on AES 256-bit encryption. We encrypt it with keys that are transmitted securely through the portal.
Okay.
So that means if when the UPS or DHL, while it's in transit, if someone gets it, powers it on, there's nothing they can do because the device is fully encrypted.
Gotcha.
And that key is supplied through a separate secure channel.
Okay.
So let's take a quick look at what it would be when it arrived at your location.
Okay.
So the first thing you're going to do is get this and open up the front and open up the back door.
Okay.
It's going to come without additional packaging because it's sturdy. It's built with a ruggedized container.
Okay.
There's no additional shipping material required. So you open up the doors and you basically plug in your power.
Okay.
Regular power that you need. And you can plug in the networks.
Okay.
So we support SFP plus 10 gig Ethernet connections, as well as an RJ45 10 gig Ethernet connection as well for transferring data onto that. So what this is the job itself. What I'm looking at here, this is the job that describes the data box itself.
Right, so after we filled in all that information you showed me a moment ago, this is the resource group that'll get created that shows me the process of me getting my box.
Yeah, this shows you the job, yes,
yeah, the
associated
job
with that. Now, this is one we prepared earlier. It's not the same
one. Sure, absolutely. But it shows me it being processed, being delivered, now that I have it. And this is where I would also go and get that key that I would need to then unlock the box when it arrives.
Exactly. Okay. And so you can see here in the device details, you'll see this is the secure locations where you're going to get that information.
Gotcha. So then once I have this plugged in on my network, I can go in, enter in this information, and pretty much unlock the box so that I can now start putting my data on it.
That's correct.
Okay, great.
And this is the very simple web interface that you will come to.
Okay.
So this is on your network. Imagine this is on your network plugged in. You would come to this in order to provide the key that you needed in order to unlock this device. Now, this key was provided through the Azure portal itself.
Okay.
And so here, you can see this is an example of once it's plugged in and unlocked, what it actually looks like.
Perfect. And so then I can configure this now so that I would then be able to go to a normal Windows machine or whatever I want to and then navigate to this device and start copying.
Once this device is on your network and unlocked on your network, it looks just like a NAS.
Got it.
And so what I'm going to see here, I can even see from this local device, the local web interface that's there, there's credentials for the SMB shares that are there.
Oh, okay, great.
And they're also secure, unique. So it means that even while it's on your network, only the administrators of this system are able to copy and see the data that's put onto the device.
Okay.
So there's SMB credentials and setup, and as well as NFS as a protocol as well that you can use to copy data onto that.
Got it. So at this point, I am assuming I would just go into Windows Explorer and then be able to mount these new shares using the credentials that you were just giving me.
Exactly. So what you would do, you can see here, this is me browsing the server that's on the network, and I can see that there is three shares created here. One share for, and each of them, the naming convention is relatively simple. There's the storage account name for the storage account that's coming into, and the storage type that it's bringing data into, Azure Files, or Block Blob, or Page Blob.
Gotcha.
And so if I go into the Block Blob, I can go and create a folder, which could be the container name.
Okay.
And then under the container, any file that I copy into that will become and represented as a blob in Azure.
Perfect.
And so I would then use things like RoboCopy, things like that that I'm going to use to copy the data in. Those sorts of tools give me the most concurrency and the ability to fill this up at a very high rate.
Gotcha, and verify that everything was copied successfully. It's all in, there's nice integrity there. Then I close the doors, take it off my network, unpower it, and then I ship it back.
That's exactly it. The device is always checksumming and verifying the data as it comes in.
Perfect.
You can get a full manifest of all the data that's on that system before you ship it.
Okay.
And then once it's ready and ready to go, it will then get picked up by the courier, taken back to Azure. Once it's in Azure, we'll upload all of that data for you and give you a full history of all the transactions to make sure we verify that the data has made it. And once successful, we would then wipe that device.
Perfect.
That device is cryptographically erased using a NIST certified or NIST compliant process to make sure that the data is inaccessible. And then the device is ready for the next person who wants to order it.
Awesome. Thank you so much for sharing this stuff with us. This is very interesting technology. We are learning all about Azure Data Boxes here on Azure Friday.